petty with your time.
Hey, what's up? It's your girl, Kelly Howard, and welcome back to Be Less Petty TV, where it's all about being less petty with our time, space, and our energy. Today's video is all about the struggle, because it's real. It is real. I know that sometimes we look at other people that have things going for themselves, whether in their career or in their lives, and they seem to have it all together. Like, damn, it just seems so easy for them, right? Will Smith's a great example. Most people look at Will Smith and are like, oh my God, life just seems so easy for him. But Will Smith is also 20, 30, 40 plus years into who he is based on the habits that he has acquired over time. That is not to say that he never struggled. That just means that we're witnessing the aftermath of everything. We're witnessing the part where it's a lot easier for him now, and the struggle isn't as real as it is for maybe, let's say, you or me. And so when you think about that, just really put into perspective that everyone has their things that they're always trying to work through, and it's never going to go away. It's never about not struggling. I think life is about finding the balance in the struggle, right? And we all have different levels of struggle. Some people have emotional imbalances, financial imbalances, spiritual imbalances, physical imbalances. It all depends. Some people have a multitude of those imbalances together all at once, and it is okay. Me, I tend to struggle more emotionally. That is something I find myself dealing with, but I've also put into place things that help me through that. So instead of spending hours a day trying to just get over the emotional hump of even wanting to live the day, because that used to be the case for me. I used to wake up and spend hours just trying to be in the day. Like taking away from hours in the day, just trying to exist in the day. And then I had to figure out ways to make that a little less of a struggle for me. Meditation, writing, right? These are things that I do as soon as I get up now, because it helps me deal with the day and struggle a little less to have to deal with the day. You get it? So life is really about finding those things that help balance the struggles in your life. It's not about being without struggles. And it's about knowing that we all struggle. We all struggle at different periods in our lives, and it's going to change. It's never the same. Like right now, my struggles with having two teenage daughters in their senior year is a little bit different than my struggles will be next year around this time when they're off in college. So it all depends on what your circumstances are. And it's very important to keep those things in mind when dealing with the struggles in your life, because we can sometimes be so narrow-minded and be stuck right here in this moment and not know that, for one, the struggle is short-lasting, and for two, if we can just remember that this is part of the journey, then it'll all be over soon. And that's not to say that, and I don't want to put that in the terms of, like, you know, if you have cancer, you'd be like, oh, well, this is just part of the journey right now and it'll all be over soon. We all have, like, I have multiple sclerosis. So the initial shock of having multiple sclerosis was a different part of the journey than today with how I deal with my multiple sclerosis. Now I take medication. Now I do certain exercises or work out or, you know, eat certain foods because I've had to position my life around this particular struggle. Now I struggle a lot less with the ramifications of that disease than I did before when I was just learning how to deal with having it. So that is what I mean when I say it gets, you know, once you understand that it's part of the journey, it's a lot easier to deal with whatever it is that you're struggling with. So I hope this helped. I felt like I was a little around the corner, up the street, and down a hill with everything. But the point is, struggle is real. But that doesn't mean that the struggle kills, because it doesn't. And in fact, if anything, the struggle makes us stronger. The struggle makes us wiser. The struggle makes us figure out how to be a little bit more improvisational in terms of balancing life and creating the ways that work for us, because ways are going to be different for everybody. I may have a certain way of doing something that really, really does help me in the midst of my struggles that may not work for you. And that's okay, because you might have a way that doesn't work for me. Everybody has their system. And And it's important to know it's okay to have your system. It's about perspective too. How are you looking at this? How are you looking at your life? How are you looking at this hiccup, this struggle, this problem? How are you looking at it? Are you looking at it from a perspective of, oh, this is the worst thing ever and I can't believe I'm going through this when everyone else isn't? Or are you looking at it kind of like Thomas Edison looked at the light bulb, right? Reporter asked him, hey, how does it feel to have failed 1,000 times before you invented the light bulb? And he said, I didn't fail. He was like, creating the light bulb took 1,000 steps. That is a completely different perspective on that. Exact same scenario. Did you fail or are these steps? And so I've had to look at my life like that too, in so many different perspectives. Like I said, I'm a very emotional person. I had such an emotional week and I had a moment where I was really sad. And then I got sad about the fact that I was sad. I was like, oh my God, I'm sad. And I was like, oh my God, I'm sad that I'm sad. Why am I sad? Now I'm sad. And then I had to say, but wait a minute, Kelly, this is a good thing. What's good about it? You've noticed that you're having this emotion. You've noticed why you've had this emotion and you're able to actually see it. You're actually able to identify what you're going through versus just being in the sadness and saying, I'm sad and I don't know why and I don't know what's happening. No, I was able to clearly recognize what shifted my emotion. I was able to clearly sit with that feeling and deal with it from a more internal standpoint of knowing this is why I feel this way and this is what I can do in the future to prevent it or maybe not prevent it. Because maybe it isn't to be prevented. Maybe it is to be just what it is. Sometimes sadness, happiness, discomfort, frustration, curiosity, confusion is all a part of the journey. It's all a part of the human existence. It's okay. But the struggle is still very real, especially in the moment, right? It feels like it's life-changing. I went back and read some old journals, and I'm gonna wrap this up. I went back and read some old journals and saw like the things I was going through at that time. And it's so crazy because I don't even remember those things. I was like, oh shit, I did this? I went through this? But we don't remember because at the time, it seems like the world's biggest struggle. But to know that it is just a moment. It is just a moment and that moment will pass and there'll be a new moment and then that moment will pass and there would be a new moment. And our life is just composed of all of these various moments and neither one of them are to be taken more seriously than the next. It is to be really just embraced, like, okay, this is the moment I'm having right now. And in time, this too will be over. That was a lot. So that is my video of the week. Thank you guys so much for tuning in to Be Less Petty TV. Please do subscribe, share, comment, like. If you ever have anything specifically you want me to talk about, please do email me at belesspetty@gmail.com. That's right, belesspetty@gmail.com. Email me. Let me know if you have anything that you need clarifying on or if you got some petty shit in your life that you'd be like, I wonder what Kelly think about this. Please send me an email. I appreciate your viewership on every level possible. Thank you so much. I've been your host, Kelly Howard, and I hope to see you back here sooner than later. Bye. With your mind, be less petty with your blame. All that petty shit is love. Be less petty with your friends. Love first, make amends. Be less petty with your life. Be less petty with your wife. Okay. Be less petty with your mom. Be less petty with your job. Be less petty. Be less petty. Be less petty, baby.